Now we're going to make our third circuit. To make an LED pulse, we need to give it a voltage that ranges between 0 and 5 volts, not a voltage that is 0 or 5. And to do that, we use PWM, or pulse width modulation. PWM allows for a pin to be an output between 0 and 5 volts. And to do this, it swaps really quickly between high and low values. And this is the same principle as most dimmer switches work in ceiling lights. This animation here is exactly what is going to be happening with the LED. So as that period of the PWM signal being high increases, the brightness of the LED increases. The wiring of this circuit is simply going to be an extension of the last circuit we built, where we're just going to add another piece to this overall puzzle. To use PWM, we can't use the onboard LED anymore, and this is because if we look at pin 13, it is not able to use PWM. So instead, we're going to use pin 3 and wire it to an LED. If we move over to the camera, I've still got the circuit from before wired up. So now we're going to introduce some more complexity. First thing you should do is unplug it before we start playing with electricity. And like the diagram, we're going to take our LED and we're going to place it so that the shorter leg is connected to ground. Keep in mind that an LED will only work when it is plugged in the correct way. It will not power on if it's in the opposite way. So the shorter leg needs to be connected to ground. I'm then going to take a resistor and I'm going to plug it into the same row. And then I'm going to take my cable from the end of the resistor and plug it into pin 3. And that should be all the wiring we need for this circuit. Before we start programming, I need to introduce one more function that we'll need to use. The function we are going to need is analogWrite. And this is to give an analog voltage to one of these pins. A value of 0 is for 0 volts, and a value of 255 is for 5 volts. So knowing this, we can go to Arduino and start coding. And with this new project, I'm going to start like we did before and initialize the variables we're going to use. This time, we're going to do things a little bit differently, where we use variables to allocate pins. And this is simply to make code easier to read, as the comments are kind of in the code when we use appropriate variable names like this. So to start, we're going to init the pin numbers or initialize. We're going to have an integer, which is our LED pin. This is going to equal 3 because that is what we hooked it up to. We're also going to have our button pin, which is 10. From there, we're going to initialize some other variables. So we're going to have our button, which will be the same as before. It'll be a boolean, either on or off. And we're going to have the brightness of the LED. And we're going to set it so it starts at 0. Now this brightness is what we are going to vary as we press down the button. So the plan for this little project is to make it so that the brightness of the LED will increase when we press the button. So in the setup, we want to initialize the pins. And we're going to have the LED pin in output. And we're going to have the button pin in input. And that is all we're going to need to use in the setup. So now we're going to move to the loop. And this is where we're going to start using a control structure from before. We're going to use an if statement. So at the start of the loop, we're going to read the button. So like the last piece of code, we're just going to digitally read the button. And last time in digital read, we just put the number 10. But instead, now that we've allocated a variable for it, we're going to put in button pin. And as you can see now, we don't need to keep writing 10 in all these functions and ask ourselves, what does 10 mean? Because it can get a little bit confusing. So here we're just going to read the button using our variable we created. I'm just going to write a comment here to tell myself what I want to do and say, if the button is pressed, we want to increase brightness. So we're going to write if, and we're going to say that if our button is high, so the high voltage, so we have true, false, high, low, they're the same things to Arduino, and we're going to start our function by using a curly brace. And when I click enter, it will also put the closing brace for us, so we don't need to do that. We've pressed the button, our brightness is zero. The first thing we're going to do is increase it. We're going to do that using plus plus. This is going to increment the brightness. That's one of those compound operators from before. The next thing I want to do is, when we're incrementing this variable, if we hold the button for long enough, it's going to get past that 255, the maximum value for analogWrite. So we're going to use a modulo compound operator to make sure it stays within that range. We have brightness, percent equals 255. That's always going to keep brightness in between 0 and 255. The next thing I want to do is I want to analogWrite. So out to the LED pin, we're going to give the current brightness. And we're going to add a short delay. We need to put this delay in because this loop will actually be running very fast. And so if we don't put it in, we actually won't be able to see the visible change in brightness. So now we can just upload that to the board. So I'm just going to plug in the board again and click upload. Cool. Now if we go over to the board, as I press the button, the LED will get brighter. Now it might be a little bit hard to see the change in brightness at the end, but that's not only because of the camera, that's actually because of the LED as well. And so one thing I'm going to implement is a way to make sure that this brightness is changing the same amount as we press the button. Now it's not going to be changing exactly the same amount, but for us, it might as well be. Knowing that circuit worked, I'm going to quickly go back to the slides and introduce the serial monitor. The serial monitor is going to allow us to pick a better top value than 255 for the max brightness. The serial monitor allows the Arduino to communicate with the computer using serial communication. We're going to need two main pieces of code to do that. Serial.begin, which will allow us to set the rate at which communication will happen. The Arduino UNO is going to use 9600 as a communication rate. If you set this to a different value, you'll get absolute incomprehensible garbage. So make sure it is 9600. If you're using a different board, you'll have to find out the value for that board. We're also going to use serial println, which is going to allow us to print a value onto the next line of the serial monitor. Now we can jump back into Arduino and introduce those things. All right, so in the setup, we're going to need to start the serial communication. And to do that, we're going to do what was on that slide, serial.begin and 9600. We're also going to output what the brightness of the LED is. So I'm going to put this here just so it is run every loop. Obviously, where you put it will determine when it is printed. So if it's printed in the if statement, it will only print when the button is pressed. But I'm just going to put it there just so it's always printing. There's serial println. And we're going to print the brightness. I'm going to upload the code again. So as before, as we press the button on the LED, the brightness will increase, but we get this weird plateau at the top that we want to get rid of. So on the computer, I'm going to go to tools. And click on serial monitor. And as you can see, we've got a string of zeros right now. And this is the current brightness of the LED. So if I press this button, we'll see that number increase. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press the button and see what value is on the serial monitor when it looks like it's at max brightness. So I'm probably going to stop about there, which seems to be about 95. So if I go back to the code, and instead of 255, I'm going to put in 95. And so effectively, using that modulo operator, Now the maximum limit of brightness is 95. If it's 100, brightness is going to get chopped down to 5. And so we are making our analog write now in between 0 and 95. So if I now re-upload the code, we've now uploaded it to the board. And if we go to the camera again, if I press this LED, it's going to get brighter, and then it's going to drop to the next cycle a lot quicker. Now, it still might not be quite as visible on the camera, but to me, it looks like it's always increasing at the same rate. So now we've learned about control structures and how we can PWM out to a pin. We're going to build up into an example that is going to allow us to automatically play the Dino No Internet game on Google Chrome. So that'll be in the next few videos.